friends. I could not wait to get up and paint for you guys this morning. It is bright and early because that seems to be the quietest that my house is. There's no overflowing of footsteps and skateboards and that type of thing going on in the house. It's one thing about doing this in the summer. It's like a rotating door here at the Horn House, which I love. I love having the kids in the house, and I like that they want to be here. So anyways, I've got my coffee in my Cindy Winch coffee cup. I've got my painting, my composition ready. If you remember, I did this one in the composition video. It's my little daisies, whimsical landscape. I have my towel rag, my brushes are ready, my paper palette. And I do apologize, last video I realized I didn't show you my paint as I was putting it down. So I tried to scooch everything over so you can see what paint I'll be putting down. My water cup, my gel media, my scissors, and all my paint. Now, knowing that this painting, I wanted to do collage, I've gone ahead and picked out my papers ahead of time. When I know that I'm going to use paper as a prominent element in a painting, I try to go ahead and pick the paper beforehand. And then that helps guide me, I guess you could say, into what colors to use. And this palette is called The Sweetest Thing. And the color scheme is tangerine, which is just right up my alley. There's a lot of gorgeous oranges and yellows and this like seafoam green. It just really is gonna guide me well. You can really see it on this page, these colors. There's a nice little gray. So anyway, this palette is a little bit different for me. It's a little more muted, but it is still my thread. It's kind of sherberty. That's why I'm so drawn to it. So I'm going to be pulling colors from my bin that kind of match this. Now, there's not many elements in this painting to paint. There's just the flowers, the hearts, the ground, and the sky. So honestly, there's not many colors. So that means ground, flowers, sky, heart. So, and then this little line. It's really just five colors. Really have to think about what I'm doing ahead of time. Anyways, so knowing that these centers are going to be some tone of yellow. In particular, I really like this one. There was another yellow in here. There's a chevron. And, you know, I might throw in a little wild card. I kind of like this one, too. It has more of an orangey. I really like it. So I'm going to put this out, especially this lacy chevron one, to kind of be my guide for my colors. And I really like doing this. I love using scrapbook paper in my work. And I have my gel medium, by the way, ready. I may have mentioned that already. But anyways, okay, so I was thinking about using purple for the background because yellow and purple are complements of one another. So if this is yellow and this is white, these little petals are white, the background would be pretty awesome as purple. Look at the scrapbook paper here, and there's really not any purple in it. Not that I can't deviate from the scrapbook paper, but I'm like, ooh, I really, really like colors that are in that. So I might just stick to the scrapbook paper colors. This one is called Beach Glass by Martha Stewart. And that would probably be almost like a perfect match. I really, really like these greens too. So I might use Melon Ball and Pistachio Mint for the bottom. This one's called Pea Shoot. That's funny. It's kind of like that game. What's that game that the kids play with the pea shooters? I can't remember. My kids are so past that. And, you know, it might be nice to divide the two colors up with like a red or an orange or like a red orange. Ooh, maybe like this shrimp color. Look at that, y'all. Oh my gosh, it's coming together. It's coming together. And of course I got my white. Now I really still like this white. When I'm painting, I like the thickness of it. The white that comes in this type is really transparent on my black canvas. Ooh, that's kind of nice too. I might have to throw that in there. So my background, I might just kind of swish around a bunch of colors. That'd be nice, right? Wait, these can be the background. This could be the sky. This could be the ground. And this is the in-between. What do y'all think of that? I like it. I like it. I like it like that. Okay, sorry about all the funny little noises I make in the videos. I can't help it. It's one of those things, it just comes out. You should see me in the classroom. I'm probably gonna totally embarrass my son because most likely he's gonna be in my class next year. Have I told you guys? Actually, I have told you guys online, but I don't think I've mentioned it in my videos yet. I got a job teaching high school art and I am beyond excited. I'm going to be teaching what's called Visual 1, which is the class that they all have to take to move on. Our high school is set up. It's really cool. It's really cool. We have what's called block scheduling. And, okay, I'm being a documentarian. Remember, I'm taking pictures of my process. Lord have mercy. Why is this on me? Oh, that's a piano. Sorry, guys. Okay. Anyways, our school is so cool. It's set up on block. So there are four blocks in the day. So the kids get four classes. I only have to teach three classes. Pretty awesome, right? And let me take a sip of coffee. Okay, you guys, I am so rambling. I'm sorry. I can't help it. It's like, you guys are all my friends, and it's Saturday morning, and we're sitting around, and we're painting, and we're drinking coffee. It's just to me, you guys are all right here with me right now as I do this. I can't help it, and I jump conversations, but I had the best new coffee. I will show you a picture of it. It's something I just randomly picked up at Kroger. It's in a tin. It has, like, a little Mexican label on it, and I bought it because I needed the tin for a decoration for this party I was doing. So now that's the only coffee I drink. But anyways, back to high school. So I'm going to be teaching Visual 1, which is it's going to be an hour and a half class. Can you imagine having an hour and a half with high school? I'm just so excited. I can't stand it. And I'm going to be teaching that. Basically, it's kind of already laid out for me. And we have to start. I have to start with, like, cave art and have to go all the way up through to modern art by the end of the semester. It's kind of like art history collides with studio art in one kit and caboodle. And I do have to, like, it's kind of what makes me nervous is I have to pre-test them. It's called an SGA. Why it's called an SGA, I don't know. When I was growing up, SGA meant Student Government Association. I have to give everybody an SGA at the beginning, at the end. And that kind of tells them how I'm teaching. Fun, right? And I'm teaching photography, which cracks me up because I don't know anything about it. Although I take pretty good pictures. So anyways, but because I'm teaching photography, I got a killer room. Got this huge room because I have to have computers because I have to teach, you know, digital photography. And they have some crappy program. They don't even have Photoshop Elements. I mean, I know they probably wouldn't have Photoshop, but oh my gosh. So anyways, I just can't even think about it yet. I'm too busy trying to finish up this e-course for you guys. You guys are my focus right now. Then I'm focused on that. So anyways, I'm teaching high school art and I'm excited. But my son might have me in his class because he signed up for it. You have to sign up. You have to take Visual 1 to be able to take pottery and photography, sculpture, painting, drawing. It's set up like a college. I mean, how awesome is that? Anyways, back to painting. I need to quit talking about my new job. I am using the Martha Stewart beach glass right now. And again, I'm putting it down very thin. I'm hoping you guys can see that pretty good. See how thin it is? You can even see the brown. And I try really hard to make it smooth and not goopy. It's one thing that I've noticed that a lot of my students in, like, my in-person classes do. It's like, you're just trying too hard to put it on too thick. It is okay to layer. Here go those voices again. Yeah, I can't help the voices. I think I would love to be a stand-up comedian one day, but I have to learn how to not laugh at myself and pee myself because I think I'm pretty funny. Anyways, see, I'm getting too thick around there. I don't like those lines it makes. You know when it's too thick, it makes those funky lines? So, anyways. And again, a lot of people art camp here in the studio this summer, and my kids were like, Miss Jenny, why can't I just paint the background flat and then paint on top of it? And you guys know what happens when you don't do that, right? Because if I were to just paint this whole background turquoise and then put the flowers on top of it, I wouldn't get these joyful little black outlines all around it. So that is why we use the chalk and we paint around it. So I'm gonna put this on fast forward for this boring painting the background part, and I will see you guys back in a minute.
Just before the dawn, when the light's still gone, shine, shine your way. And you may not know where to go to shine, shine your way. Open road, but it's still dark. Build a fire from a spark and shine, shine your way. Feed the feeling in your heart. Don't conceal it, then you'll start to find, find your way.
No one can stop what has begun. You must believe when I say,
all of your tears will dry faster than the sun.
So much to learn, and now it's your turn to shine, shine your way.
There's a feeling deep inside, you can let it be your guide to find, find your way. And there's no time for us to waste, gotta take a leap of faith and fly, fly away.
Don't have to walk, now you can run, nothing can get in your way.
I have finished the background. This is just the base coat though. It's all the beach glass by Martha Stewart. And again, it's all filled in and I can really see my negative space now. And I wanna make sure that I am getting, I gotta think about this because these petals, you've gotta make sure there's some blue between each petal. Otherwise, it's gonna be like a white blob. Black blob. Gotta make sure you got enough blue between each one. Okay, so I'm gonna rinse, 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 rinse. And I didn't even touch that color, but I guess I'll put that color on top. So now, and again, you gotta shake, shake, shake. Gonna use this melon ball. And I can already tell this melon ball is gonna be a little too transparent. So I'm going to use both of them. It's not too bad. And I think I'm gonna try to use a little bit of a different brush stroke. I think I'm gonna go up and down. With this, I kind of did random. I think with this, I'm gonna go up and down because grass does kind of grow that way. Our grass is certainly growing that way lately. We have had one monsoon after another. It is unbelievable the rain we're having. Kind of scary rain. It comes through with like a vengeance. Took down a tree at the front of the house last week. So, ooh, I really like the way this color vibrates. Oh, ah! I can get that off. There we go. I saved it. So, what might be cool, I try to put a little texture in here. I have all these gel mediums that I got samples for our art retreat. I've never really used them. This might be a good chance to use some of that kind of thing. And this is, a cradle canvas. So you can decide, I think some people asked me that last time, how to finish it off. I do tend to frame everything. I just feel like it looks finished. But for my little gallery in Birmingham lately, I have not been doing that. She likes them unframed because then they cost a little less money. But I tend to just paint the edges black because that seems to be accepted. You could wrap it around and paint the edges the same color that you're doing the, like this green, I would wrap it around to green. You know, and I might even do that. I might even stamp. I could put like "You Are My Sunshine" or something. I could stamp around the edges. Okay, so I guess I'll do that. It's funny how ideas come to you when you're talking to yourself, right? Of course, I probably should have painted the edges black as well because it's not going to look quite the same. Yeah, no, it's not. Since I don't have the black under it, it doesn't quite look the same, but that's okay. Might even sand the edges a little bit. When I'm done, get some paint. Daisies are my favorite flower. And I love to paint them because they can be so whimsical. I mean, you can just really simplify a daisy like whimsical art is. It's more charming and has a little bit more character. Has more personality. There you go. I like to think that my art reflects my personality. Okay. Let me paint the edges of the blue real quick. It did take a minute. Let me get that. I definitely want to put that red in the middle. Look how different that looks on the difference between that and that. I don't know if you can see it as well as I can. It just doesn't have as much depth because it doesn't have the black under it. That's what it is. So what's y'all's favorite color to paint with? I am definitely drawn to the blues and the greens. These oceany colors. Although I have really been getting into the pinks lately. I think because there are so many varieties of pink. When you go to the Michaels and you're buying these little craft barrel paints, there's so many shades and tints of pinks and reds. There's really not that many shades and tints of like yellow and some of the other colors. I don't always, yellow's a hard color to paint with because of the transparency of it and us using the black canvas. It just makes it a little more difficult. Okay. And what I'm doing with the edge is there ends up being kind of like a little bead. I don't want that bead there, so. Okay, so all my edges are painted out. Sorry. Everything just has like one coat on it now. It's looking a little rough. In fact, you know what? I'm going to take a picture so you can, and I'll post it on the, okay, a shadow issue again. I had that problem last time. So, you see really well, it is very rough looking. This is just the beginning though. I mean, it's about layering and about the process of adding. Okay, so for the red, I think we had decided to use this like shrimp Americana multi-surface satin shrimp. Love shrimp. I love shrimp to eat. I love this shrimp color. Okay. And because I'm right-handed, I probably should start on the left side and work my way over. Otherwise, I'm going to drag my hand through the whole thing, which would not be good. So let's get that shrimp on there. It is watery. I might not have shaken it up enough. It's very, very thin for some reason. That's okay. Might even put some light little white stripes in it too. Okay. So there is that. Then I've got my hearts, which are red. So I'm gonna use this. Ooh, it's called lipstick. You see how red that is. Lipstick in the hearts. Ooh, that's very red. All these little heartsies painted. Now, again, you know, look at that red. It's not turning out the best because it's so transparent on this black, but nothing that a couple of coats won't take care of. Now, I don't really want to use pink. I don't know why. I want to use more bolder colors with this one. It's raining hearts on top of the daisies. Well, that might be cute. I could put he loves me, he loves me not on the edges, I guess. I'll figure out something. I'll stamp something on the edges. I'll show you guys when I'm done. Okay, that's looking better. This paint dries so dang quick. All right. What's left? The daisies. So let's paint. The white and the daisies. And this brush might work. Let's try this one. Okay, cool. Now this is that thicker paint, so it is going to go on a lot more opaque and a lot heavier than the other paint. I am trying to manipulate my brush strokes so that they have more of a petal look. I wouldn't want to do my brush strokes going side to side. I want them to go the length of the petal, because that is the direction that most of the petals, little veins, you know how they have like that little texture in them? That's the direction they go in. So you want to be mindful of that when you're painting. You want your brush strokes to kind of mimic the object you're painting. And even with that thick paint, I'm going to have to put a couple coats on because it is white. And I bet you guys are thinking, how is she going to get those centers in there so perfect? Well, do you remember my trick with the tracing paper? And of course, that's the one thing that I forgot to bring over, so I'm going to have to put you guys on pause a minute and go get it. I think this would be a petal in here, wouldn't it? This is where it gets confusing when I do all this overlapping. Speaking of overlapping, I can mention that right now. Since I probably didn't mention that in the other videos. When you want to create a sense of layering and a sense of depth, overlapping is an awesome way to do that. By putting this flower in front of this flower, see how those are overlapping? It creates that sense of front and back and that little bit of movement, painting. The other thing you can do to create a sense of depth in a painting is depth, not death. My kids always at school go, what? What? Depth. Another way to do it is to have different sized objects. Like the hearts are much tinier than the flowers, obviously, because I want them to look like they're further away in the sky. So those are just little tricks. Little tricks that you learn along the way as an artist. Is if I put all those daisies in a row, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it would have been cute, but it wouldn't have had as much energy and movement in the painting. By doing what I've done here, putting this flower in front of this one and that type of thing, it creates a sense of depth in the painting. It makes it more exciting visually to look at. Coming along nicely. Look at that white popping off of there. Oh, goodness. Actually, should have started on the left side of the canvas. When you're right-handed, you should start on the left side and move your way over. Because then your arm doesn't drag in the wet paint. Big one. I like the way I put this big one in the middle. And I have to be honest, a lot of what I do is just kind of luck. I don't know how else to say it. It's luck. It's the way I just, you know, when you've practiced and you've drawn as much as I've drawn, sometimes things just fall into place. So some of you guys just need to practice and just keep falling into place and it'll just all come together. You guys are doing awesome. You get so excited when I see your paintings and you're putting yourself out there. I mean, the fact that you're here means so much. I mean, there's a lot of people out there that won't even try. They're like, oh, I can't paint, or I can't do this, or I can't do that. But you can, if you just give it a little bit of effort. Well, you have to have the desire to. I mean, some people just don't want to. I know plenty of people around me that have no desire to be creative. I cannot imagine a life without being creative. And a lot of them have excuses, you know, oh, I don't have time, my kids, da, 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 da. But I tell you, if you know, for me, because I am a creative type, if I don't create, if I don't make, if I don't do, if I don't come down here, I'm not a very pleasant person to be around. I've actually started reading a lot because this summer I had that little surgery, and then just prior to the surgery, I really didn't feel good. And I really didn't feel good. And so the last thing I wanted to do was be down here because I wanted to just lay down. So I started reading, and I am really enjoying that because that's like a different type of creative outlet. I'm one of those people that I read a book and I visualize the whole thing the whole time. Are you like that? I bet you're kind of like that too. Okay, so I have got the base coat completely done on this painting. I am so excited. Okay, so let's see. What am I going to do next? I am going to start back over. I'm just going to start back over and go to the background and work my way to the middle. And then probably what I'll do is let it dry on its own and then add the center. So this might be a 2-video thing just because it's nice to let this dry on its own, not force it, before I add the collage parts. Now, you notice, I don't know if you can totally tell, but this is, I'm trying to use that second color a little bit. That second color is sea glass. Oh, that's so funny. It's just, I had no idea I picked sea glass times two. See, I wonder if it's too much like that. I'm thinking it's too much like the ground. Maybe I'll just stick to my original color. I think I will. Okay. Looks like it's gonna be another beautiful day, and then we're supposed to have afternoon storms again. We've been out of school almost a month. Should we have been out of school? I think 4 weeks. This is our fourth week. It's so hard to believe that. The art camps were fun. They were just real time consuming. I did 2 day camps this year. Normally I do 1 day workshops, 9 to 12, but this year I thought, you know, let's do 2 days, then I can do more. And really, it was awesome with the big kids. The little kids, they did great too, but I think they got a little anxious. And I mean, it was like a full school day, and I was constantly entertaining them. So now I know how real classroom teachers feel, because it is like nonstop. See, at least with teaching art, they come and go. You know, it makes it, it's much more energetic and a dynamic classroom setting, because it's nonstop rotating door. It's like 45 minutes, okay, next. 45 minutes, okay, next. But those regular teachers, man, they got them all day long. Oh my goodness, I had this one that just, I was like, he exhausted me. It was hilarious. And then I had, in my older group, I had this little girl that just incessantly talked, and I thought, oh Lord, that's probably how I was. I bet that's how my teachers felt about me. Oh, it was, and she would talk about nothing. And she had, you know, I'm from the South, and I'm from Georgia. I'm not from Georgia. I'm from Alabama, but I live in Georgia. This little girl had the accent. It was the one that you guys picture in your heads that I probably had, but I don't, because I'm not as bad as a lot of people. But, oh my God, her little voice, and it was so, so Southern drawl, it cracked me up. She just talked incessantly. One time I just looked at her and I said, sweetie, you have to stop. You have to stop for a minute. You just have to stop talking. Because a lot of times she was talking over me when I was trying to give instructions. I'm like, you got to stop. They're so cute. A great thing about art camp is they all sign up to be here. You know, they all love it. And they all want to be here. Because no parents can spend that kind of money for a child that doesn't want to be here. So that's, I think that's why I'm so looking forward to high school, because they sign up for it. I mean, they're asking to take art and they're asking to be a part of the course. It's not like a teacher's planning period. It's gonna be a lot more work, I'll agree, because I'm gonna have to grade, and I look forward to that part. I love writing lesson plans. I'm already thinking I have to start with cave art, and I'm thinking I'm going to start with cave art, talk about cave art, then I'll to translate it to modern day graffiti art, because in a lot of ways they have very similar attributes, cave art and graffiti, you know, because it's all about painting on a wall and telling a story. Now, some of the graffiti art is not exactly content appropriate, but here in Atlanta, we have what's called the Beltline, and I've run a half marathon on some of it. It's just amazing. They took out a railroad and made it like green space and paths, and there's like folk art along the way. And then the other thing they've really started doing is the overpasses, because there's a lot of interstate roads and it's a lot of underpasses where people live. They started painting murals under all these underpasses to discourage the graffiti. Oh my gosh, they are unbelievable. And I really want to show these kids that we can take something that's kind of you know, seen as destructive and the graffiti and make it beautiful, that it can serve a purpose, I guess. Like, there, art can serve a purpose in so many different ways. So, the graffiti art on the Beltline and underneath these overpasses is, you know, it's so beautiful in such an urban, rough way, you know? Like, I wouldn't necessarily want a painting like that in my house, but I can certainly appreciate it, and I'm going to be showing it. I'm thinking it would be cool to even do, like, a field trip, like, have kids meet me and us do the Beltline and look at it. We don't really have field trips much in our county because cutbacks on money. I cut field trips out a long time ago. It's kind of sad, isn't it? I love taking field trips. I remember going to the Barber's Dairy. I remember going to the zoo, of course, the museum. I grew up in Birmingham. We had Barber's Dairy in Birmingham. Over here, the big thing is Mayfield, I think. Mayfield. The Yellow Jug. Okay. So I've got a second coat on this blue. It's still looking a little rough, but I feel like I need to add a little spunk of something. You know, something, something. Maybe it needs like some little bit of coastal waters. I want to put something behind these petals to kind of bring the petals a little further forward. Let me see if that'll work. My daughter just texted me. She doesn't want to go to the mall because she's too tired. Okay, guys. I have a 13-year-old daughter that doesn't like to shop. Is that not the craziest thing you have ever heard of? Went to Urban Outfitters last week, and I don't know if y'all have Urban Outfitters or not, but always loved Urban Outfitters, and of course I love Anthropology. But Urban Outfitters used to be more junior-y, you know, like, I'm like, what? I mean, like, clothes just didn't fit. But recently it's like they had new buyers, and it's all kind of, it's a little sacky, it's a little, it's just cut different. Like lots of, like I bought the other day the cutest hoodie thing. I mean, I don't even know how to describe it. It's just so cute. I got it on the clearance rack too, of all things. And I bought the most amazing pair of shoes, and I bought another top. I mean, it was during a baseball tournament, and Will's girlfriend and I went in there, and she was like, ooh, Miss Jane, I like that. Ooh, Miss Jane, I like that. And it was kind of fun shopping with her, because when I go with Maylee, Maylee's like, that's too expensive. I don't want that, Mom. Mom, you look stupid in that. And Tony, on the other hand, was like, oh, I like that. Ooh, those shoes. You got to get those shoes, Miss Jenny. So it was fun. Yes, we're in that new stage with the girlfriend. It's so funny. They've been together. He asked her out on the Ferris wheel at the county fair. It was on her birthday, or near her birthday, in, I guess, September. So they've been together for a while, and they're just so cute together. I can't stand it. And fortunately, I guess, whatever. I mean, I shouldn't say it's a bad thing, but her family and our family have gotten to be friends. We even went on spring break together to the beach. Yes, I know. We're like asking for it, aren't we? Because, you know, they're young. You know, they're going to eventually break up, I bet. But we sure do like her, and we love her family. And actually, I took Tony and her little brother and her mom to the lake with us last week, to my dad's lake. And we had so much fun. Her little brother is the same age as my daughter. Oh, he's so cute. And he's so easy to be around. They get along great. I don't think, I mean, they'll probably never date, because it's like brother and sister seeming to them, but anyways. It is a very fun stage. I like being a teenage mom. I think that's why I'm excited about teaching high school. Okay, y'all, this is really looking good. Remember what I said? If you just keep layering and you keep layering, just keep layering, just keep layering. Just keep layering, just keep layering. Sorry. Again, it's one of those little outburst things. I can't help it. Ooh, la la la. Oops. Ooh, grabbed the wrong paint. I really like this darker blue underneath all that. Come on. It's really nice. This is going to make somebody's house very happy when they buy it. Wah! That red is almost, that red's bothering me. On your screen, it looks black. On the screen, I'm looking at the movie screen. I have it like, so I can see what I'm doing. It kind of looks black. Maybe I'll change that color. Maybe I will make it pink after all. Okay. I could probably keep adding and adding and adding, but I need to stop. I need to stop and move to a different area. But you know what? I haven't done the bottom much justice. Let's get in there a little bit. Okay. I keep saying okay, and then I keep seeing places I want to add paint to. Okay, so let's add the green again. Again, I'm going to try to make it look kind of grassy. Just put like little splats of color down. We're headed out for the beach tomorrow, friends. I'm so excited. Beach is my husband and I's happy place. You know what I might do? Ooh, I got an idea. Let's see how this works. What if I take back my paintbrush? Well, you guys probably can't see this, but this is creating a nice grass texture. So what I've done is I've got the dry paint and then the wet paint, and I'm scratching into it to make it have, see, I let that side dry too quick. You guys can see it. I'll take a photograph of it. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me turn it around. Yeah, you see that? Why not? That was a good decision. Set that one right there. So I'm happy. It was a very good decision. Every once in a while, just doing something random like this, you never know until you try if it's going to work. I'm putting a lot more in there because I like it. I like it. Okay. So, those red hearts are bothering me. So, let's see. There is a really pale pink in this paper. And I know I'm not going to be using, oh, that one's not even open. Let's use some baby pink on these hearts, because they are, even on the screen here, I'm looking up and I'm like, oh, they just don't look good. They're too dark. They are too dark. But it's nice to have that red underneath it, because I'm kind of, you know, I can't paint it perfect, so you'll see a little bit of that red. Giving me fit. This one, I don't like the shape of it. There we go. And of course, you know, until I erase the chalk, I can't really tell that these look like hearts. Oh, and then that salmon color again, too. Ooh, yeah. See a second coat on that salmon. Or shrimp, not salmon. Fish. Does look like a shrimp. Love me some shrimp. If you want shrimp, you gotta go to Gulf Shores. Oh my gosh. Gulf Shrimp is the best shrimp. Okay, that looks great. I like that little. Okay, I think I need another coat on this white. I just do. I wasn't going to do it, but I think I do. There's too many brush strokes that aren't looking good. Yeah. But it's going to make it, if I do the brush strokes right, it'll kind of mimic the flower petals. Does that make sense? I was trying to explain something to my dad the other day about a running stance. He's like, Jenny, you are just not making sense. I'm like, oh. I hope I make myself a little bit more articulately clear when I'm teaching you guys. This is one thing I love about flower petals is those little lines they have going through them. Ooh, you know what? Speaking of which, I guess I could scratch into it. Make the petals look a little more real. Some point today, I got a pack for the beach, and I swear, every time we go to the beach, I feel like we take everything but the kitchen sink, you know, because you got to take your chair, because we stay in a cheap place, so you have to bring your chairs, your umbrellas, you're on this, you're on that. It's just so funny. Cooler, I don't like to go to the grocery store when I get there, so I take a cooler of food. We got a new car, so it's bigger, but it's funny, it still gets filled up. Oh, I like that better. Okay, this is gonna move it. Okay. That is looking good. I'm gonna do a little something here though. Just because I feel like I need to. Maybe. Maybe not. Let's see. I think I'm gonna put a little orange stripes on that. On those, and that shrimp. So I'm using spiced pumpkin. Let's see how that looks. You can't really see it. But it creates a little more dimension. I love putting patterns and dots and stuff like that around. Oh, you know what would be cute? What if I... I'm thinking. A row of dots. Oh, that's good. So I'm just using the back of my paintbrush here, and I'm making these little dots. When I post the picture of this, you're going to be able to see all this so much better. This is a part of that, you know, your little art bank that I talked about last time. Having a bag of tricks that you're like, things that you like to do, things you like to add. It just makes the canvas come a little bit more alive. And you know what? I think I might put some of these in there. Can't really see them. But it gets it gives you like a little, oh, what is that? Oh, you know what? What if I use a different, oh, I know what I can do. Gray. Shake it up, so it's not gonna work. use some gray. Yeah, the back of your paintbrush can do all kinds of things. Yeah, I like that. Just a few, not too many. Just gives it a little bit more energy. Sometimes I just don't know when to stop. I'm just gonna keep adding. Yeah, I like that. Oh, you know what I should do? Oh, I should be doing that on the edges. Let's do that. Let's do these dots on the edges. And then when I stamp, it'll have like a little bit of a pattern underneath it. It'll be so good. You guys are going to be like, woohoo! Gee, that's awesome. I forgot to put the little turquoise stripe down. I mean the shrimp stripe. Let's do that over here too. Maybe I should put, I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to put some green too. I mean, might as well. It's whimsical art, right? It's whimsical art. Art that is whimsical. I think I'll put pink on the green. I don't tend to do this, so I don't tend to put anything on the edges. It's always normally framed, so I'm kind of always at a loss about what to do with this. So this is kind of fun. And you know what I might do at the very end? I might put like white stripes on top of everything going on. So do you feel like it needs a little bit of white? It's getting very cute. Very, very cute, cute, cute. Maybe one more coat on this pink flower. I mean the pink hearts. Yeah. That's just what the doctor ordered. Okay. This is so fun. Now, what I'm going to do is take a picture of it, of course, because I am documenting as I go, what I'm doing. Maybe I'll do one this way. I keep forgetting to do one this way. I gotta stand up. I can't show you what I'm wearing because I'm in my pajamas. Which is not very exciting. I just wear a tank top and pants. I have to sleep in pants. I don't know why. I think because the doggies like to cuddle me under the covers and I like to have to have pants on when they do that. Okay, this is looking really cute. So that yellow, those yellow centers are going to be awesome. All right, so I'm going to stop the video and get reset up for doing the collage part. So I think this has been a fun video and hoping you can see it all. Here's all the polka dots, not many polka dots. Might have to work on that a little bit. But anyways, come on, awesome. These black dots are bothering me though, so we gotta get the collage on those. So I gotta get it dry and reset up so that I can demonstrate how to get those circles on there nice and perfect. But I will be back in just a minute. started to create the collage centers. And I know you're like, well, how in the world are you going to get perfect circles for inside that? I have a piece of tracing paper, and unfortunately I couldn't find my tracing paper pad, so this one's got stuff on it, but it'll do. So you're gonna, what you do is you put the tracing paper down on top of the object that you want to fill with the collage. So I have this circle right here, and now make sure you're gonna leave yourself a little black ring. Sorry. So it's that one. And I like to cut, it's so much easier to manage if you have a smaller piece. So that's that one. I have picked up all my scrapbook paper. And this one has this really cute, scallopy, like the top of it's a little different, so I'm totally gonna use that. Because this is that piece that's a little more orange. Okay. So I'm cutting it out, okay, and voila, look at there, awesome, right? So that is not dust cutting out, these scissors are heavy. Okay, so that's looking good. I did forget to do something before I started, and I am out of baby wipes. You know, I like the baby wipes better. I did forget to wipe off my chalk. So let's do that real quick. I'm just gonna use a damp rag. There we go. Actually, this kind of works a little bit better sometimes. Woo, look at all that. Oh, just, let me hold that for you so you can see. It's awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now the old me would have totally like gone back in with a Stabilo pencil and fixed some of this, but I really like the little nuances that it's making, so I don't think I will. Okay, just like that, all the chalk is gone. All right, let's put this back on here. And the reason I do that is you don't want to have to be rubbing the chalk off after you put the gel medium down, because if you put gel medium down on top of chalk, it's there forever. Does that make sense? You don't want to leave that behind. Okay, let's get this little baby one done. And again, I'm making sure that I'm leaving a black gutter. And I've chosen three different types of paper. I really liked this little flower pattern. It's kind of cute, and it might be too much. We're just gonna see. I'm gonna try to stick to my yellows in it. I'm sorry, I keep moving the scissors backwards so you can't see what I'm doing. Okay. Here's that one. I may not have cut that one big enough. Well, maybe it's supposed to be this way. Okay. I want to do one of the big ones with the yellow. Anytime you want to put scrapbook paper on something, this is the way to do it. Because then you can still get your little black gutter, that's important. And you can make it perfect. Because these were some wonky shaped circles. Oh, let's see. All right, so if I've got this yellow here, I think I'll do this one the same. I might have to pull that chevron paper out after all. I wasn't going to use this chevron one, but maybe I will. Okay. There's that one. Awesome. do that, this over here. Yeah, you should just buy a pack of that. This tracing paper is so cheap. You just need to buy you a pack of it at like Michael's or Hobby Lobby. I have a notepad somewhere of tracing paper. I just don't know what I did with it. During art camp, my kids played school or something, and oh my gosh, I keep finding stuff in the weirdest places. Really like that yellow popping on the bottom. So let's use this flower one again. I think I'll stick over here, but I need to make a bigger one for that. That's not big enough. It's too much black. Too much black. Gotta get some yellow in it though. Here we go. I love these little pads of paper. Most of the time I find them of all places at TJ Maxx, and they're like, you know, $3.99 or something like that. And now that one's too big. Let's cut that down just a smidgen. For those big paper packs, there's just almost too much paper on them. Okay, so I need to do this one. This one's going to be tricky. This is why you definitely need tracing paper, because this is the one that's tucked behind. And I, in a never in a million years, would be able to cut that perfect. Oh, and the dogs are barking. Sorry about that. They feel like they need to bark at everybody that comes by. It just slays me. It's like they're allowed to walk through the neighborhood, guys. But they are good guard dogs, I guess. This one looks like a moon shape. There. I like that one. Okay, so what to do for this one? I think I'm gonna do this. I like that one, and it's solid yellow, so it's gonna be good. I have an odd number of flowers. It's funny because I didn't talk about that. And composition-wise, if you tend to do things in odd numbers, it's a little more appealing. I don't know why. Maybe that's a wives' tale, but that's what I was told when I was younger. But, you know, like, if you did two, I guess if you had them in variety of sizes, it'd be one thing, but... But I like my odd number of flowers. Okay. So, I have my gel medium, and this is a giant thing of it, yes. Oh, gosh, okay. It's stuck closed. I always paint the surface, and it does tend to leave a little bit of a shiny ring, which I don't like, and I'm painting the back of the paper too, by the way. I don't like the shiny ring. Kind of annoys me, so I really try to be careful and not get it on top. You could put it on top of your paper, but if you did, you would almost want to paint like the whole thing, because it does change the color. I mean, this is matte, but it still changes the color. So again, I'm painting the wood and I'm painting the paper. You want to be careful and not have it on your fingers when you're putting it down, because it can kind of tear the paper a little bit. This paper papers, like just enough paper, just enough to give the composition a little bit more excitement. It's a little more whimsical, a little more fun having all this on here. I like it. Okay. I used to add a lot of collage. I used to put collage on like everything. And words. I used to honestly, I would find a quote and paint the quote. Paint the quote. Hello. Somebody's here to say hi. Come here. You want to say hi? He's here to say hi. I know. Oh, the kisses. I swear this child has the longest tongue. Cracks us up. Lawrence, I don't think you need this, baby. Having a baby again. A lot of dogs have like fish breath. I mean, he doesn't eat fish, but it smells like dead fish in there. Oh, it's bad. It's bad, Lawrence. He has some spiky breath. Look at there. Just like that, I'm done. Now, you got to make sure you put your brush in the water and you close your gel medium up because this is like $50 worth of gel medium. Done with this. Oh my goodness. I love it. What do you think, Lawrence? I think Lawrence approves. Sweet boy. Okay. I am very excited, except for I just noticed one little place I did not put any paint, and that is really going to bother me. So let me read. Oh, where did that flower go? Did I not do that one? I did do that one. I forgot to paint it. Let me attach that. And I just noticed one place that I did not paint. How in the world did I miss that? Oh my gosh. Let's get this on here. Oh. Yep, you hear him? I mean, he's downstairs. I don't know what he thinks he's gonna do for downstairs. I might have to put this in my little powder room. This would match. Would look really cute in the powder room. I have this giant camper painting I did years ago in the powder room. I mean, it's huge. It takes up the whole wall. It's so awesome. It's one of my favorites. One of those things, you know, when painting doesn't sell for the price I want, I just don't sell it. I hang it up in my house. I gotta stop. Sometimes you just have to, like, slap your hand and say, stop it. Okay. So what do y'all think? Love it. So all done. Again, tracing paper, scrapbook paper, working on odd numbers, overlapping composition. This one turned out really good. So I'm going to do one more video for you guys with the painting. I think I'll do another tracing one so you guys can see another tracing painting. Just to be refreshed on that, but I hope that you're enjoying the course and it's going well for you and you're getting a little more out of it. I hope I'm not being a little mean in some of my comments, my blog post. I did lose an entire post the other day. I got so mad. I was writing about color and made it was the most amazing post, and I was just tired, and it asked me a question, and I said, yeah, sure, I want to delete that whole post. And that's not what I meant. I meant I wanted to delete that one section, not the whole post. So anyways, I got to start over with that, but it's coming along really well, and I hope that you guys are enjoying it and getting a lot out of it. Alrighty, we'll see you later. Bye.